All right, it's a Thrifty Thursday on Rising, and today we're talking about stocks. Amy Novakovic with Nova Wealth Management joins us to break it all down for us. And
hi.
This is almost like speaking Greek to some people, right?
I know.
Good morning.
Yeah, and it is.
And by the way, one of the words, and no offense to our Greek friends, by the way, and it's not Greek, it's diversification.
Right.
A word that is very important. Tell us a little bit about what it really means when it comes to investing in stocks and how it affects people with this kind of crazy market that we're in today.
Well, it's important now with the market in the last few weeks hitting new highs, sometimes a few days in a row. But have you ever heard the term, don't put all your eggs in one basket?
Yes.
And that's simply put what it really means.
Okay.
If you have a portfolio of multiple stocks, that's much better than owning just one or two.
Okay.
And we can do an example real quick. It's probably the easiest way to explain it.
Yeah.
If you have only two stocks in a portfolio, and one loses 50% or cuts in half, your portfolio has now lost 25% versus if you own 10 stocks and one, same situation, cuts in half or loses 50%, you've now only lost 5%.
Okay.
So you just kind of increased your chances of having a better long-term returns and decreased your chances of your overall risk.
Right.
Of course, we can't erase risk completely.
Right.
We would like to, but we can't. But you can, you know, reduce your chances of being kind of overextended in certain areas. And what diversification means in the bigger level is you should own multiple asset classes. You should own some cash, some bonds, or fixed income, as we call it. Equities or stock, speaking Greek, instead of just one area. Because think in 2008, if you had owned all financials, you might have gotten in trouble.
Right.
So you want to own different things that don't move together.
Okay.
You know, trying to make sense of this.
No, it does. And you said putting all your eggs in one basket.
It
all kind of makes sense. You're bringing this down into good terms here for the people
that
understand.
I'm trying.
I mean, good.
Because
it
is, you know, like equities and fixed income and all
this.
I mean, you just want to make sure you don't have everything in one place so that when something happens, you're at risk.
Right. And before we run out of time, I want to make sure you can kind of break down the terms yield and total return when people are discussing investing and things like that.
Yeah, because it's confusing when you're talking about different types of assets, it changes. So when you're talking CDs and money markets, total return and yield are actually the same.
Okay.
So when you're talking stock or equities, if you have a stock that's $100 and you're getting a $2.50 dividend or income stream, your yield is 2.5%.
Okay.
Your total return adds the gain or loss. So take a year, that $100 stock goes from 100 to 105, that's 5%.
Okay.
Plus your 2.5, there's your total return.
Okay.
Whereas yield is just the income stream, 2.5%. And so you take the 105 that the stock is now, and take your 2.5% dividend, and it changes when the stock goes up.
Okay.
So now it's only 2.4% or 2.38%-ish. So yield changes, whereas total return is just adding the two together.
Okay, well, you're a woman that
I
knows that what
she's
talking about. We have your information on our website, by the way, too, for those of you who want to know more.